My work seeks to speak about the various systems deny women the right to free expression and to a full realization of their lives and bodies. I lived in Mende Land, Sierra Leone, West Africa, in the late 1970s. Years later, I would read of the horrors that were affecting the villages I once blossomed in, loved, and called my home. As a solo woman traveler, little girls became my chosen family. They guided me, taught me, protected me, and loved me. It is their lives that became monumental to me. These mixed-media ceramic sculptures are encased in protective ceramic forms that partially hug the fragmented bodies. So she is frozen in that moment of time as her life is being deconstructed by war. Each ceramic piece is accompanied by a mixed media, the doll, the ball, the shoe, and a new shirt. These objects are the physical echoes of little girls who once played with joy before they became soldiers in someone else's war. Girl soldiers. My work seeks to speak about the various systems deny women the right to free expression and to a full realization of their lives and bodies. I lived in Mende Land, Sierra Leone, West Africa, in the late 1970s. Years later, I would read of the horrors that were affecting the villages I once blossomed in, loved, and called my home. As a solo woman traveler, little girls became my chosen family. They guided me, taught me, protected me, and loved me. It is their lives that became monumental to me. These mixed-media ceramic sculptures are encased in protective ceramic forms that partially hug the fragmented bodies. So she is frozen in that moment of time as her life is being deconstructed by war. Each ceramic piece is accompanied by a mixed-media, the doll, the ball, the shoe, and a new shirt. These objects are the physical echoes of little girls who once played with joy before they became soldiers in someone else's war. Girl soldiers.